Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing analyzing graphs of functions. In our first example, the question is y a function of x? So to do these examples, we're going to use something called the vertical line test. The vertical line test says that if you can find a vertical line that crosses the graph of your function more than once, then your function is not a function of x, right? Y is not a function of x. So in this case, in part A, we have a circle. So can we draw a vertical line that crosses the graph of this more than once? Well, yep, I just did right there. So the answer is no. This graph does not define y as a function of x. What about in part B? Can I find a vertical line that crosses more than once? And the answer is no, it's impossible. No matter how many vertical lines I can draw one here, draw one here, draw one here, they all cross the graph exactly once. This means that yes, this graph does define y as a function of x. And in part C, can we find a vertical line that crosses more than once? Boom, absolutely, crosses twice. So in this case, the answer is no, this is not a function of x. If you can find just one vertical line that crosses more than once, then it is not going to be a function of x. And if no matter how many vertical lines you draw, they all cross exactly once, then in this case, the answer is yes, it is a function of x. All right, let's do something a little bit more challenging. In this example, we are given a graph and we have to answer a few questions about the graph. Let's start with the question of where is the function increasing? So when you're thinking about where a function is increasing, you want to read it left to right. You see here, it's decreasing, 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 decreasing all the way until it gets to negative 2. And then at negative 2, it starts increasing. Keeps getting bigger and bigger and bigger all the way until it gets to 5. And then at 5, it starts decreasing. Notice how I'm talking about the function in terms of x values. I'm saying this happens at negative 2. This happens at 5. That's how you talk about functions. You talk about the domain. So when you're answering this question, you want the x values. So it's going to be increasing from negative 2 all the way to 5. So from negative 2 to 5, the y values are getting bigger, and so the function is increasing. And you always use parentheses, so it'll be parentheses negative 2 to 5. Unfortunately, the notation is a bit confusing because here it says negative 2, negative 1, but we're talking about the point, whereas here we're talking about an interval, all the numbers between negative 2 and 5. So one of those unfortunate things, but context should make it clear. The function is getting bigger, the y values are getting bigger between negative 2 and 5. How about decreasing? Again, you want to look at it from a left to right perspective. So it's getting smaller, smaller. The y values are getting smaller, so smaller all the way until you get to negative 2. So from negative infinity to negative 2, the function is decreasing. And then at negative 2, it starts to increase again, stops increasing at 5, and then at 5, it starts getting small again. So that would be 5 to infinity, right? So from 5, I'm going to use red here, from 5 to infinity, it goes on forever to the right, the y values are getting smaller. Remember, your answers are always x values, okay? And you always want to use parentheses. Relative minimum, let's do this. So a relative minimum is a y value that is the smallest y value relative to the y values around it. That's why it's called relative. Some people call it a local minimum. So in this particular example, negative 1 is a relative minimum. I use a different color besides red. So y equals negative 1, or just negative 1, is the relative minimum because negative 1 is smaller than the y values around it. You could write the ordered pair. You could say it occurs at. Make sure you throw that language in front of it. So occurs at negative 2, negative 1. Different books will ask slightly different questions. Some books will say, what is the relative minimum? In that case, it's negative 1. Then they'll ask, where does it occur? So sometimes they'll want just the x coordinate or they'll want the ordered pair. So it occurs at negative 2, negative 1, and it is negative 1 because you have this little dip. It's the smallest y value. The relative maximum is going to be 6, right? 6 is the biggest y value relative to the points around it, right? Relative to the other y values, 6 is the biggest one. It occurs at, you would write the ordered pair 5, 6, or you would just say it occurs at x equals 5. Again, different textbooks will ask different things. But the key point is relative mins and maxes are always y values, they're function values. So whenever you have something like this, that's going to be a relative min. Something like this, it's going to be a relative max. Hopefully you've learned some mathematics in this video. It's a lot of really cool math. Hopefully it's been helpful. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out Chegg for more videos. Good luck.